Hello, and welcome to another episode of our how-to series. This week we are looking at the new EZVIZ range and how to set up your account and manage your cameras via a browser. We should say before we start that everything we cover in this video can be done via the app on your smartphone. But we still wanted to cover it because we understand some people aren't comfortable using smartphones, and also accessing your cameras via the browser is not covered in the user manual that comes with the cameras. Also, to do everything you see in this demo, you will have to use Internet Explorer, as other browsers are not compatible. As you can see, this demo was recorded on a Mac using Safari browser, but we used an emulating feature of Safari to make EZVIZ think we were using Internet Explorer. With all of that out of the way, let's dive straight in with setting up an EZVIZ account. First off, we need to go to EZVIZ's website. You can find this simply by googling EZVIZ, or if you prefer, the full URL is www.ezvizlife.com. Once on the site, you'll want to click the register button in the top right of the screen. You'll be taken to a standard account setup page. You'll see a number of boxes. To complete the setup of your account, you'll have to fill in username, password, and country. Make sure when you enter your password, the strength bar under the box is full and it classifies your password as very safe. Before completing this page, you will have to choose either to set up the account with an email or phone number. We would suggest, if you have one, to use an email address. And finally, you have to complete the robot test and enter the verification code. Once that's done, tick the agree box and then hit next. A box will then pop up telling you you have been emailed a verification code, so you then have to go to your emails, open the email, and copy the 4-digit code into the pop-up box and hit OK. You will then be taken back to the EZVIZ homepage, but don't worry, if you look in the top right of the screen, you will see your username. Click on your username and you'll be taken to a login page. Again, don't worry, this is just a security feature to make sure it is actually you accessing your account. So just enter the username and password you just created and hit login. And here we are, your account is now set up. Now, obviously the first thing you're going to want to do is add cameras. So first off, click the big red Add Now button. This will take you to a page where it will automatically start scanning your network for connected devices. You can add cameras automatically or manually. So if the automatic search doesn't find your cameras, don't worry, just click the tab that says Add by Serial Number. A box will pop up prompting you to enter the 9-digit serial number. This can be found at the bottom of the white sticker attached to your camera. Type it into the box and hit search. Within seconds, the corresponding camera should appear. If it does, then click the big plus symbol in the corner of the picture. Another pop-up will appear asking you to enter a verification code. This is a 6-digit code that you'll also find on the white sticker. After entering this, click OK again. After a few seconds, another pop-up will appear asking you to change the password from the verification code to something more secure. One important thing to mention is however strong your account password is, do not use the same password for your cameras. Make sure each password is original. Once you've decided on a password, hit OK, and after a few seconds your camera should be activated, and a final pop-up will appear which will ask you to set a date and time of where your cameras are. Once you've clicked OK, the pop-up will disappear. Then all you have to do is click the big OK button and you'll be taken back to your homepage. And where the big red button had been previously will now be a big play button, which when clicked will take you to a live feed of the newly connected camera. And there you are, you've added a camera. And if you want to add more, simply repeat the process. Now the final thing we want to cover in this video is some of the other features you'll find when viewing your cameras via a browser. First, we'll start with a homepage where you'll see a link to one of your cameras. And just above this, in the right hand corner, is the plus symbol for adding more cameras. To the far right of the homepage, you will see two buttons, the first labelled Messages. This takes you to a page where any alarm or motion detection notifications are stored, and if there are any unread notifications, a corresponding number will appear next to the bell symbol on the homepage. The second button is labelled Sharing Invitations. This will also show a number if you have any invitations to share footage pending. Going back to the top of the page, the next tab is Gallery. Clicking on this will take you to a page with two tabs on the left hand side. The first is Live Video, which shows you the links to the live feeds of all your cameras. And the second is Local Album, which shows you any stills or videos you have captured manually from your cameras. The next tab at the top is Messages. This is the page where you're taken to if you click the Messages button on the homepage. As you can see, the notification system works just like your emails do, with a Mark All as Red button and a search bar. The final main tab is System Management. This tab is split into five sub-tabs, the first of which is Device Management. This is where you can access some of the key features of each camera you have connected. The second tab is Friend Management, which is where you can add friends to share videos with and manage the video feeds they are allowed access to. The third tab is My Account, which is where you can edit your account information, add a profile picture, and change your password. The fourth tab is Access Configuration, which is where you can allow specific mobiles and computers to access your account and cameras. The final fifth tab is Local Settings, which is where you set the save location on your computer for any stills or videos that you record from your cameras. And this tab also lets you set whether or not the website remembers your password. You should only set it to remember if you're using a private computer and not shared devices such as office computers or laptops. That is pretty much everything you need to know about how to set up an EZVIZ account via a browser, as well as all the basic features you would need to know. All the specific camera features we will cover in each camera demo, but if you do have anything else you would like us to cover in any video, leave it in the comments below. Thank you for watching and subscribing. If you haven't subscribed already, please do by clicking here. Check the description below for links to our Facebook, Twitter, and Google Plus feeds. Follow the link here for our webshop, and if you want more videos like this, click the playlist up here. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.